On this fine Monday, what happened this weekend? I actually didn't catch nothing that made me laugh. Apart from another local television station, Auntie Mama Bwatu Jira. You also the guys that dressed up like the funny coffin meme guys. What station was that? We won't name them. But I want to take a moment and say, actually, I find their themes more interesting. There's one when they had a reggae something and they had cushion set. I was like, okay, resty go. You know, so yeah. What else went down over the weekend? Well, let's share. We shall share. My name is Tina VS1. Name of the show is Scoop and Scoop, and it's proudly sponsored by Metropolitan University. Let's get it. Mama Jona. Ekisooka okujja mu mutwe gwo bw'ogamba erinnya Mama Jona ki? What goes through your mind the first time when someone just says Mama Jona? Or what goes through your mind when someone says, first of all, she's an ex-convict? Secondly, she's not just any regular ex-convict, she was a... But Black being her usual self over the weekend gave me some feels. Now, mujukira najalo nentula ningamba even Bad Black has been contacted by the ministry to talk about COVID-19, because you all remember that's the time when every truck driver that was coming into the country was pretty much positive. So our president would come on national television and he's like, please, our daughters, stay away from these truck drivers. Please, please, please. Y'all wasn't getting the message. Next thing we know, bam, wham, Bad Black is on air. She's telling us and our sisters. Come on, our sisters. Sicho. And she's there advocating for them. Minister Waba. Government here, though. It went well. It did. Actually, when I saw the initiative, I was like, yes, Bad Black. I even remember we threw shade and we told her, honestly, the government just acknowledged you and you want to go back to your simple, simple ways. Oh, cry, Bad Black. But the only one I can quote for quote was, Musasule sente zange. That one, I got it. Those are not my words. That's quote for quote. She said, give me my money. Now, according to Bad Black, for all of you who do not know, let me fill you in. According to Bad Black, when she was approached by particular individuals, they did not talk about getting paid for it or not getting paid for it, innit? But she still gave her voice. They did the video, they did the audio. Sicho. Now, according to her, some other people that actually did the same thing that she did to spread awareness, mbu bobaba sasude. And ha, she's saying, teba musasude, katia yagala zize. So she went, got herself lawyers. Who knew Bad Black knew lawyers? Anyway, she has been in the system. She has been in the system. It pays to be a... Did you just say she's asking for 500 million Ugandan shillings for a 2-minute video clip? Yo, scratch that. I am leaving this job. I'm joining Bad Black. 500 million. And ready. See, emitwala atano. Emitwala meka. Million meka. Wow. And according to her, why this amount is not even alarming to her, because she sat up and she told us, ministry baji was 600 billion zona zagenda wa. Eh? Buna mustika ba mteka mtauni ba tagenda na kula banga titufulu mayo. Mkama katonda. Why is my money? I was like, ooh, speak, Bad Black. Speak. Say something. Now, when it comes to if what she did is right or if what she did is wrong, tebi nkwatako. But when it comes to, how am I going to put this? For me, this whole situation is just, it's going to out so many things, because if a person like Bad Black has come out and said, look here, you contacted me, I did this, I did that, I didn't get money. We do not know if the fault is on her or if the fault is on the third party that took her to the ministry. We do not know. All we know is that she wants money, she gave an offer, she gave a service, and she wants to get paid. Whether she was liable to be paid or not, according to the government, they say, it was voluntary. There was no contract. It was just Burundi Bwansi. If I'm bad black, I understand what I'm just saying now. It was voluntary work and all of that. But if you ask me, if I was bad black, walai nange nandizi sabi. When you listen to the numbers and figures of money that are going in between different agencies in this country during this COVID-19, Abi, I will beg for money. Every 5 seconds, Simanya FIFA 500 billion has gone. Every 5 seconds, 200 billion has gone. Why would they refuse to give her girl money? What is the thing about the Ministry of Education? Oh, no, it's not education, it is Ministry of what? Health. The ministry should have just paid bad black. Because you see, bad black can become a kainja munga toyo. Bad black is a chick who has nothing to lose. Bad black is a person who will throw your secrets out in a flash. Bad black is not afraid of anything. So, with all the monies that umanyi ezita itamu atete mwabuzabuzange zitalimu, because we know there is already corruption happening somewhere. That's a fact. It's a given. Give it years, they'll say, you remember the COVID time? Yeah, this amount went through the ministry. Obu sente bu 500 million. Why I'm calling them 500 million? It's because in my country, amounts like that do not scare us. Mumuwa siri, Bad Black is going to put this clientele on blast. Atebwa ngamba a clientele. Y'all know what time it is, because this girl has slept with half of the country. And not just half of the country, the influential half of the country. So, why do you want your dirty linen out? Just put on the side, take her out of public, and just give her whatever you can. And just siri, because she's broke too. Times are hard. But then again, wait. Did I hear that she actually was also promised to meet the president? Before the president wants to come on, would she search it out? Oh, you have to go and see the president. She's not friends with, she's not friends with Bala. How sure are you? Bad Block may not be friends with Bala. How could be friends with Bala? So two different individuals. Two different individuals. Anyway, she wants her money. I am team give Bad Block her money, because we all know for a fact there is plenty where all that came from. Yeri ndako. All that money that we're giving in as donations, remember it? People are giving 100 million, 300 million. So imagine if all the money that, let's say, all these other companies put together, we just go and buy testing kits and test everybody. Nene center that we just again, lockdown is the lockdown, the open up, the open up, the community cases is the but driver we wait up. Today morning I got up to, there could be a rumor that we're going to go back under lockdown. I'm like, why? What have I done? What have I done? So, the ministry is honestly unfair. When it comes to Bad Black, she had every right to stay in her home and not talk about anything or do anything. Even if there was no contract that states that you were supposed to pay her, you know, Burundi Bwansi, other boy, pat on the shoulder, mwoyo kwa mwade yo. Ah, city care, because right now, we're starting to ask the questions you don't want us to ask. Njogera sichiru mam. Ugandans are starting to ask questions that you don't want us to ask, like, where is all this money? Zigendawa. Ziyitamu hu, ziweta, zichama, zirimu, trusty fund, ziriwa. If we can't even pay for the simple, simple basics, Yerindako has Nightil finally given us masks. We waited on the 10th. I thought they said they have started giving out masks in the border areas. Munatuka kodi. Katinze njira ntu deka. Nga ninze mask yensange. Bad Black. Me as Tina. I am just saying, why? Ask for your worker money, even if you do, even if you are not legally entitled to it. Ask for your worker money. We can all ask for our worker money if we want, but you ask for your worker money. Musasure, Bad Black, Minister Wabama. Simple, to be one. Ha, ngatufu dewa Bad Black, I would like to take a moment to say, mama fino oliotia. Nyinebi buzo biyange, ngo muntu. Because you know, Mama Fina is one of those very down to earth people. Mama Fina yagala nyo yamba. Mama Fina alibibie, alibibie, uli alinga mama, ngapo ulira mama. But did you all just notice that every year she has a new husband? What happens to her husband? Why do... Okay, apart from the other one that died, rest in peace. Then she picked up another one very quick. Like, I want to understand what's her... Because I feel at this rate, Mama Fina should be the girl child advocate for if moving on was a person. Think about it. Her ex-husband died. It was so gruesome, Bambi. Nakaba, nakuya tukua tanzijukira. Twali wano, namantu babukedde. Waita obangaji. Ngatula baba gaba mahali. Waba wachali edachi kasatu. Nga ka video kagundi kaito. Wachali edachi kasatu. Ngatula gaba mahali mara. So the last guy who did the kwanjura and all of that, what happened to them? We make me thinking well, this is all about love. But there's a bigger business going on that we don't understand. Because, first of all, she must be such a very, 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 very nice woman. Because we must jam same dako. Mbaga. To all you to all towards Gaundoka could be a Denise and no. So I never be a mabi. But then again, Babanga Mulunja Kusukawo. How come they never stay? So anyway, she has a new lover. I hear he's Sweden based. Kavidi yotekali Sweden. Never pengi pengi. But I pengi webale ku introducing a Mama Fina to Be. I think it's Peng who did this. Anyway, she's going to introduce her Sweden based lover. I don't know how and when, but they did a pre Kwanjula photo shoot and she was with her brother and everybody lost their ish. I'm sorry, I can't keep up with these stories, even I can't. Anywho, so yeah, but you know Kwanjula obakwa after COVID tetumanyi ndoza weba gulida wo and yeah, I still have so many questions though. Like seriously, Zenchakara Budia Buza Mama Fina Bibuzo binu tabi mubuza and I like her because she's honest. Mama Fina, explain to us or tell us if we should come to you for like a simple conference meeting. You explain to us how you easily get these men, drive them crazy enough to pay for your bride price and then leave you. We have all been trying that. It is not easy to tell these men to go and pay by advice. What are you saying? We're impetent now because you know to wham bam pam. So what's she doing right and wrong at the same time? What? Like when they're just entering the relationship, they're like, she's good. Then after that, maybe they notice a chikabi to dekoye. I'm asking. Because now even J-Lo doesn't do that. And we know J-Lo for being the biggest. If marriage was something, was a person, that would be Jennifer Lopez. She put on way too many rings. Like Mama Fina. Isn't she in the same lead as Jennifer Lopez? Because they all give her rings. They go Angela, they get down on one knee. Mama Fina, me, I just want a moment, just a moment between me and you. On tuzengo mwano muto ombuli debi intubi no. Osanga! Onata saba na ba mama tenda bali ku mama tenda ngabe kuba mizimu bano nya masaje babe sibye ko baba gundire emigo mu nyumba mbuchi chinonya peta nonya bufumbo sanga ngakwa kendo tasa bana bo fresh pictures abali mu marriages alone and thinking they are married. And I mean Mama Fina, when I come out for the girl child, come and tell us. So what you do is you make them love you like this, they get smitten like this, they kwanjula you like this, you wear beautiful outfits and then you dump them or they dump you like this. I can live with that, because imagine how many relationships it would be easy to come in and out. Girls are out here bagenda kwetu gata yandisokedde kubukedde bukedde ina abakazi abasaba abasajja empeta bakubanoonya munnaffe naffe wano. I just okaba gambe ko bana, yeah, this is what happened. I swear I would give anything to just know what this chick does to make them love her that much and hate her equally.
Ah, but the story of your mugenzi Paulo Kafero nze bicha nemye bigeze nyo.
I'm trying to follow it, but you know, this is not in Urban TV's early, this is in Bukede's early. But then again, it's in my early because I am in the music industry, and Prince Paul Job Kafero was an icon. He was legendary here. He still is. Like, his name is mentioned in any and every circle. So, story in agents of it. So apparently, there's a court order to have him exhumed. Reason why they want him exhumed is because they want to get a DNA sample. Reason they want a DNA sample is because, well, there are 15 kids that either do not know a Chikacha, whether do not know Obaya Lichita, whether do not know much, who want to find out if that's their father and if that's his clan, and you know. And they also want his property. Let's just put that at the tip. I was just trying to be sensitive, but we all know that is. Yeah, that is why most of them come back. So there's that aspect. And then there's the wife. Am I right? Who says she's the wife? Tikwe. Are they legally married to the... Anyway, you're talking about being here. Who says... You will not exhume my husband. Now, Paulo Cafero's brothers come out and say the reason why she doesn't want him exhumed is because she knows for a fact that the kids are going to ask her for their property, because she has sold off a couple of property that belong to the late Paul Cafero. So, as of today, all I know is that they are going to exhume him because it's a court order. They are going to do that. Nekati nsencha tudewano. Ninechibuzo chimucho chibande ching confusing all throughout this Cafero saga. That white chick. Were they married? They were not. Aww, no wonder she's silent. But they were together. They used to perform home and away together. So she's silent. This story reeks of so much Africa that I want to gag and throw up. That I Musendala, webatu kiro kuzikula. It's not for property. It is for blood. Okay, yeah, it is for blood and property. But seriously, they asked the brother to Cafero, since the 15 kids are all here and we want to know if they are yours, and you know that Prince Job Cafero was your brother, why didn't they ask for your DNA? And then his brother mashes it up even more. And it's like, well, the court said, no, as I thought the brother was mashing it up, that same wife, Simanya basisirikirwa bakola batya, comes out and she's like, but wait, Paul Cafero was not his father's son. I'm like, whoa, wait, what? So according to his wife, she says he was not his father's son, the father that they know. That he was half Rwandese. And then the brother says, no, she's just bitter because she doesn't know her own family. I'm like, wait, what? And then he goes like, her mom came to our home as a house girl and left. When she left the baby. The baby was raised. I'm like, wait, are we talking? Are we talking about the same people here? And then... Guys, you have to understand, I'm trying to also just give you what I know for now. Like, this issue is not arranged out like dominoes. I'm like, Sibita Gera. Then, Nebajeneva Gamba. Mbu. Now, this wife has a friend who is not even related to them, but that's the friend she's been selling Paul Cafero's things with. A one-man Dave, I'm like...
the family history in this family. Nze when we tunulide byona yes money blah blah blah. When tunulide what's happening in Prince Paul Job Kafero's family. It sank home and I always tell you people these things. Bana imumanyaje muzala. Ladies, and also this goes out to the men. We have seen these things happen too many times. You remember when Pade Bitama died? You remember when Moze Radio died? Huh? Mubera one mbiza nyisa ebintu bino. Mubera one mbiza nyisa ne mugenda ne muzala mbantu babalala. You never ask their full details. You don't know their lineage. You don't know crap. Then something bad happens like this and boom. Everybody is bringing different information from inside. Hey, Jesus, can they just leave this man to rest in peace? I don't know. Jesus. Banai, Ugandan celebrities, especially you men. Banai, wizo wobola bakatambika na bana Uganda bakusibye konya abana banji. Nkwega ili degweto chigeza. Nota leka chidamo cha abana bu. Linya kulinya nenyina. Because as of yesterday, Kafero's brother says, ya abana ba amanyi, Kafero beyale kao. Bali ya abidi. Abakalia ku bintu bya kitaabo ku sente ze bakalia ku bali bana out of abiri na yakavuyo kali mu family eno. One minute the father is not the father, the mother is not the mother, the mother is not the father to the mother, who is the mother of the father? I'm like, huh? What? The last time I spoke about Palazzo, oh, I did not speak about Palazzo. The last time I was with Palazzo was actually here on set. That was after his whole South African xenophobic attack situation. Do you remember that? Is kind of an ever name gonna Twitter bana Palazzo nga ya tuchanganga Chinese. Ya tuchanganga cards enehu. Palazzo yavudeyo. Nagamba some of the reasons as to why he left America was racism. lizard Palazzo. Racism. Wow. Racism is what brought you back, Palazzo. Racism is what had you deported, Palazzo. Racism is what got you. I mean, in most ways, it is a possibility depending on the angle of the situation, but we all know. Does any of y'all believe this ish? Palazzo is the same guy who, when the xenophobic attacks were happening, decided to drive into a very insecure neighborhood with his friends, and they were attacked because they were going through a xenophobic situation in South Africa. Now, George Floyd, rest in peace. Riots all over the globe, and Palazzo again left because of racism when he was in America, when he was in jail. Racism did it all. Njukira uli sabuni gwe baita anga life boy. Achari. Oboya na mukole labana Palazzo bakwe kasabuni. Dia nyege nyege people who are they, what are they, management? Nyege management. Bana tu ina bibuzo nga fa bali ba pare ba nanyinyi kunyo ba nyanyi kuono na za fe. E chibuzo chiri jim. Are we nyegering this year? Are we going to nyege? Like, let me not. Are we going to nyege this year? All these other festivals down to Coachella in America have come out and told us either they're going to have it or they're going to postpone it or they'll see. Not nyege nyege. Nyege. 2 months to go. People have saved money from January through a global pandemic. Do you know what that means? I bet you right now, if you told Derek, that's my workmate, that nyege is tomorrow. Ajakujayo sente, basi terese through a global pandemic. Do you know what it means to hold yourself through through a moment where you're not sure if you will live to see tomorrow, but you kept nyege nyege money. Ah, nyege nyege. Ah, but now I'm going to go out to have to call. Come out. Hey, Boteng. Lately, we're friends even on Twitter. You comment and you say how much you love the show. I feel that. But what you're not going to do, I saw you trying to come for our boy, Suna Ben. But now, Suna Ben is our golden boy. We're on New Vision. We're talking about Mwami Chinyanya. Ebi nyanya biale tolu naku. Buli buwa imi dida kuful dos. You know, nchukugamba mulu watu, I have to protect my own. When you keep saying that he's not the best DJ, ebi wabi mani Slick Stewart. Ferie chinyanya mubanka chibuayo. Feno amasimu agakuba. Gasaba ye. Kati for you to ask him yet mbu, he asked something as dumb as, and he doesn't even have a Twitter account. Nabagamba, nchidemu. We trend in the bank, not on social. That is the difference. Bana mwana we chinyanya mmule, kesuna Ben. That guy is so much life, by the way. Have you watched him play? Even if you felt you were a who, soon I will just give you a hey. Kati mwaba chalimu, oh my god, yeah, bougie, we're wearing mab. No. Omune masaka chikuba, deide. Deide! Ate sente za kabushenge erize yonge. Nezange. Nezabalala. Muleke tukubise ebinyanya. Ah. Anyway. Atina Fierce One is my Twitter handle, and on Facebook we are Scoopa Scoop under Tina Fierce One. Not forgetting on Instagram we are Tina Fierce One with an 8. I'll catch you on the flip side, which is tomorrow. Don't forget we are on tonight. 8:07. I'm out. Peace.